Hi guys, today we are going to look at one more problem for SLR of 1. Let us have a quick revision. The number of stages are the major stages involved in LR of 1 parser construction. We are talking about LR of 1 parser. So here, numbering the production is the first step. Augmented production, we need to add a new or a special production for the accept state. We need to accept the grammar. In order to accept, we are going for augmented production with a new production or augmented production or special production, whatever you understand, that's fine. Next, canonical set computation. So canonical set computation, we would be requiring a scanning operator. That scanning operator I am using in this intervention dot operator. There are authors, there are bloggers, they are using at operator. This canonical set computation is the base for deterministic finite automata or a directed flow graph, whatever. It is useful for designing the automaton. So from the automaton, we will be going for table construction. Before table construction, it is good that we need to compute follow. After follow computation for each and every non-terminal, in general, first and follow is associated with non-terminals. Only for non-terminals, we would be doing first and follow computation. Non-terminals only associated with first and follow. This is the canonical set for the DFA construction. Augmented production, otherwise termed as new or special production. Next, we are going for table construction. This table only, we call it as SLR of one table. This is called as SLR of one table. This SLR of one table consists of two parts. Action table and go to table. Let us see what action table. Action table is meant for terminals. Then what are all the actions? The name itself says action. What are all the actions we can take further? Shift is one of the action. Reduce is another action. Error is another action. Accept is another action. Normally, we don't write error. We will leave or we will treat error state as empty state. Whenever emptiness is seen in the table, it is treated as an error state. Next, go to is the table associated with non-terminals. Here, what we will be doing? Simply, we will be writing state numbers. Once the table is ready with the action table and go to table, parsing action with a given input starts. We need to give a sample input. For the sample input, we need to demonstrate or we need to do the parsing action. These are all the 8 major steps involved in the SLR parser. This is what we are going to try solving the problem in this session. SLR of 1, problem 1, normally this is not given with this number. Normally in your examination or in the textbook, the problem is given. This is called CFG. This is the grammar. CFG is given for solving the problem. Given the CFG, let us consider what are all the productions. If at all augmented, for example, this would have been written like this. Slash symbol followed by T in the textbook. We need to decompose it into two different production. That is important point. Note it. So whenever multiple productions are augmented, that is not at all suitable for our problem solving. We need to decompose it into individual productions. So this is one production, this is one, etc., etc. You do have now 6 productions. That is fine. Just to have a look at it. Subsequently, you need to number the production. Since I'm using digital method, I'm doing quickly. So if it is pen and paper, you need to put number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6 production number. So first step, as I mentioned, it's numbering the production. We are done. Now we are moving towards the augmented production. What is the augmented production? Let us see. This is what augmented production. Look at. In this level, there are 7 productions are available. Very first production is segmented production. We need to start from here. Let me move temporarily somewhere so that I can show step by step demonstration for your understanding. Look at, we need to concentrate only on this portion where I am concentrating. This is the portion. This is called augmented production. E dash is the non-terminal newly I am introducing. E dash is not at all given in the problem. I need to introduce any one of the non-terminal. Choice is yours. You can introduce A dash, B dash, S dash, anything. Without dash also, the choice is yours. The non-terminal which is not available in the original grammar, you have the freedom to choose. So I have the freedom. I am choosing E dash as per my choice. So that I am choosing E dash. Producers, what is your starting symbol of this production? Very first production, left hand side symbol is your starting production. So you need to write that symbol capital E. The moment, first step is you need to write, 1 minute, first step is you need to write only augmented production. We have augmented production, E dash producers E. Right hand side, what you need to fill up? You need to fill up the start symbol of the given grammar. Our start symbol of the given grammar is capital E. So that I have filled. Now your duty starts. Canonical set computation. What is a canonical set computation? You need to work with dot operator. You need to place a dot operator before the E symbol. Capital E in front of E. Or left hand side of E, you need to place dot symbol. Then you need to state. I am stating, this is also your freedom. Whatever you like, you put. I like to give the state number as I0. If you wish, you can give state number 1. Choice is yours. That's fine. Next, dot followed by capital non-terminal. Because of non-terminal, I am bringing these two productions from the original. Let me delete this. Let me do one second. I am bringing this production from the original. Why I am bringing these two productions? Because of dot followed by non-terminal. Then after bringing the production, I need to place the dot operator in front of the production. So dot followed by non-terminal E. E productions are already available in the state. So no more action we can do. Next, I'm placing the dot operator. Dot followed by T. T is a non-terminal. Just because of the non-terminal T, we are supposed to bring T derivatives or productions starts with T. That is our objective. So there are two productions in the original grammar starting with T. So that I am using those production into the canonical state I0. So now, next my duty is to place this scanning operator dot in front of the production. So I have placed this dot operator in front of the production. That is fine. Now dot T, already we have brought all the production starting with T. There is no more duty for us. So next look at this production. Dot followed by F. It is non-terminal. Now our duty is to bring all the productions associated with F from the original set. So that I am bringing all the productions relevant to, or I am writing all the productions relevant to F. Now my duty is to start scanning the right hand side. So that I am placing this dot operator. This is the indication in order to exhibit to other people. This dot operator is the scanning operator. If I don't put scanning dot operator, how can you understand which symbol I am scanning? It will be in my mind. I can't exhibit to you guys. So that only this dot operator I am keeping. Nothing more. If I start telling I am scanning the beginning of the RHS, how you will imagine, how you will visualize? So that I am placing dot operator. That's all. So this is the first state I0 computation. The moment I have done the I naught computation, this state need to be treated as a mother state. So I need to think of all other derivatives, all other child states, because it is a kind of graph or tree structure. So I need to generate all its generatives or child nodes. For that, look at the pair dot followed by E. The dot symbol need to be scanned. It need to move right hand side of E. That means I am coming across this symbol. Whenever I am moving, I need to look at only the first production. First production of the mother state I need to look at. The dot I need to scan. I need to move here. While doing that, I need to consider all the kind of pattern, dot E pattern. There are two productions having this dot E pattern. Just because of that combination or occurrences, a kind of coincidence, we can say. And the kind of coincidence, I need to consider these two productions together when I move to a child state. Child state is named as I1. Then I am moving the dot operator from the left hand side of E to right hand side, so that these two productions I have brought to the state number I1. Yes, fantastic. Then I need to move the dot operator. Dot operator earlier in the mother state, it was left hand side. Now I have brought to right hand side. Similarly, this dot operator in the mother state, it was on the left hand side. Now I have moved on to the right hand side. That's fantastic. Now look at dot followed by nothing. So you are lucky. No more action you need to do. Now dot followed by plus. You should not say nothing. I have given you for your clarity space. Dot followed by plus. So that now it is terminal. You no need to do anything else. You can be cool. So now we need to move to the mother state. We did our justice only for these two productions. Similarly, we need to do for third production. Third production, dot operator is placed before the T. That dot needs to be moved after the T. While I am doing this job, I need to consider all the coincidences. There are two productions having such a pattern, dot E pattern, so that I need to consider in my mind these two productions together. So next state is I2. I'm calling it as I2. This state is on dot E. This state is on dot E. So that dot is moved on the right hand side. Look at now. Dot followed by nothing. No more duty for us. Dot followed by star. It is a terminal. So that no more duty for us. Now state number 2 is also over. I2 is also over. Now we need to go to the mother state. Mother state, we haven't worked on this production. If we look at this production, it is dot F. I need to move the dot operator left hand side of F to right hand side of F. So I am copying this. Next state, I supposed to create. What should be my next state is? 1 minute. My next state would become I3. Or else you can call it as state number 4. This is on dot F. This is on dot F. See. I need to write this state I have come because of this combination dot F. Now I need to shift this dot after the F. So dot followed by nothing else. So no more duty for us to do with. Now we are done with I3 state computation. We need to go back to the mother state. Mother state, we did the job till this point. Now we need to consider this production. In this production, dot followed by open bracket. So this is only one production. So that now we are going to work on this production, so that I need to create a new state. That state I am naming it as I4. This state is a number I5. This is for the operation dot open bracket. Now I need to shift this scanning operator after open bracket. Now the problem starts. What is the problem? Dot followed by non-terminal. Because of this non-terminal, we need to go to the original production. All the E combinations we need to bring. Same story. See, dot followed by E means then the same will repeat. That common sense or intuitive sense we would be having. We would be having normally this intuitive sense. So that I no need to think deeper. Dot followed by E, we have come across such an experience already. So that similarly dot followed by E, I am coming across. So closing my eyes, I can bring all its derivatives. Dot followed by E, I have brought these to production. Dot followed by T, because of that I have brought these production. Dot followed by F, because of this I have brought these to productions. The same story repeats. So now we are lucky enough. We are done till now. Similarly, we need to consider this production as well. Dot need to be scanned after the ID. So for that, now I am going to work. So this work for the mother state, still we are in the mother state. So this state, I am calling it as I5. Then this I am working for dot ID or state number 6 for your understanding. Dot ID, this is small ID, dot small ID, sorry. Small ID. That's all. So one set of combination we did the action. So starting from the augmented production, we computed I naught. Then from this we started scanning, shifting the symbol to the right hand side of E so that we have come to the state number I1. Similarly, shifted this dot operator after T, we have come to the state number I2, and so on. F open bracket ID. That's all. With that, I'm going for the ready-made one. So for your understanding, I'm trying to compute one particular stage. Rest all, I'm going to articulate through this diagram. Look at, we started with I naught, augmented production. Because of the augmented production, dot E, whatever may be the production, dot followed by non-terminal comes. Then we need to bring all the productions of that type. Then dot we have placed here. Dot we have placed here. So that, look at, dot we have placed here. E plus T. The same only, the first state what we did manually, the same is represented here in the diagram. In order to move the dot E, we reached the state number I1. In order to move the dot after T, we reached the state number I2. In order to move the dot F, we reached here. In order to move the open bracket, we reached here. In order to move ID, we reached here. In any order you can do, because here we don't have the way to do order. However, look at I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. So after reaching these all the state, this is the set of states we have reached in the first level. In the illustration, I demonstrated for these all the states. Now we need to work for the remaining state. Look at first production, dot is reached at the end. Now second production, dot is not at reached at the end. So we need to shift this dot next to the plus. That is the reason this state is labeled with plus. So we are going to new state because we already reached the state number I5. So we are labeling it as I6. You need to shift the dot operator next to the plus. Now look at, after shifting, dot followed by non-terminal. Because of the non-terminal, we are bringing all the T productions. Then we need to place a scanning operator. Dot is available here, dot is available here. Then because of the dot F, we are bringing all its production. Dot is available here, dot is available here. So this duty we are done with. Next, look at this state. One of the production, the dot symbol has reached at the end. Look at this production. Dot symbol is not reached. So we need to take our necessary step to shift. So after shifting, this is happening with a star. So that dot F, dot followed by non-terminal F. Now the problem starts. We need to bring all the productions related to F so that we have brought these two. Look at this state. Dot reached at the end. Comfortable. We should be happy. No more work associated with it. Look at this. Here, dot E is already available. I need to shift the dot operator next to the E. So that only I am doing this job. Dot E. Next, dot E, if I am moving, dot followed by, it is terminal, plus. No more duty for me. When I am shifting dot E, I need to consider all the pattern. Look at, there are two productions are of the pattern dot E pattern. That is why these two productions are brought into the state I naught. Listen carefully. So dot E pattern, how for the mother state I said, same is applicable for everywhere. Dot E pattern available for these two production. So that we have brought. Similarly, we need to work for next production. T dot. T dot pattern, there are two productions having dot in front of the T. So we need to consider T. When we are considering this T, two productions we need to consider. So that this arc is labeled with T goes to I2. This we have seen already. We did it. So that we need to connect with this. We should not do new state. Next, dot F. There is only one production dot F. Already we have seen such kind of instance. So that we are connecting to that node. Dot open bracket. We have come to this state because of open bracket. So that's self loop. It is referencing itself. This state is referring itself. Next, dot open bracket. Now dot open bracket, we are done. Now dot ID. We did already dot ID. So that we are connecting to the existing state. Now, so for now we did for this. Now look at I3. No more duty. We should be feeling happy because dot has reached at the end. Similarly, we need to go to I6. I6, this dot need to be crossed. Whenever dot T, we are considering two circumstances we need to consider. Two productions are having dot T pattern. So that I'm going to the new state I9, considering both of the production, I'm shifting this dot crossing the T. That I did perfectly. Dot is at the end. No more things associated. Dot is followed by terminal. No more duty for us. Come back. Look at here. Dot F pattern. Dot F pattern already we did. See, this F is coming here and connecting to here. All the combinations of F, wherever we do, it will come here only. Open bracket. Already we did open bracket here. It comes here. ID. Already we did ID. So where this flow is coming, here. This ID flow. So when you are drawing on the paper, you may need to use landscape mode rather than portrait mode. Only then it is possible to do perfectly. Now this is done. Next, I7. Dot F pattern. Only one. So that we are going for I9. You may ask question, dot F pattern, why you are not going here? See, look at this production is different. This production is different. Whenever dot F pattern is of different production, we need to go to new state. If it is of same production only, we need to go. Look at this F is on this production. So that I came here. This F is on same production. I came here. So please understand this carefully. Just because of F, you should not connect to here. Because this F is related to different production. So that I am moving to new state. Dot followed by open bracket. This is existing. So that I am coming from here to this state. Dot followed by ID. This is existing production. So that I am going back to here. Let us consider I8. So dot followed by plus. I need to cross. Dot followed by plus. If I want to cross, then already this kind of production only we reached here. See, this kind of production only reached here. So that I am connecting here. Dot followed by close bracket. Already this pattern has come. Dot followed by close bracket. This is the first time close bracket we are visiting. So that we are going to new state close bracket dot. Now so far now we have completed scanning this entire state. Now we need to come here. Dot we reached. Fantastic. We can stop. Then dot star. Crossing the star, this is the state. So the same production only we started at I2, we reached here. Similarly, same production we need to go to the state. F. Next, with the F movement of here. This is reached, this is reached. Done. I9, we did only one production. We connected here. I10, I11. We are done with this diagram. Now, our next duty is to construct SLR1 parser table. We need to design the table. The table must be in rows and columns. The rows and columns are go to and action. Rows, number of rows are going to become I11. How I decide I11? Depending on number of states available in the given diagram. I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I5, I6. So total number of states are I11. So that I have created the rows I0 through I11. I'm done my job. Next duty is I need to move on to the column construction. Column construction, I need to harvest all the terminals, including one special terminal, dollar. So that available number of terminals in the given grammar is these all, plus star, ID, open bracket, close bracket, dollar. So action table consists of these all. Action table consists of these are all the terminals. Next part of the table is go to. Go to table consists of three non-terminals, ETF, so that it has three columns. This is the very first step you need to decide, think. How should I design the table? How many rows it should be? How many columns it should be? Again, within the column, how many are for action table? How many are for go to table? This clarity is mandatory. Next to that, we need to go for filling the row entries. In order to fill the row entries, we must focus on this diagram only, on the state I0. What are all the things we need to consider? Let us see. We need to focus our, we need to pay our attention towards the state, mother state I0, wherein which we need to look at how many outgoing edges are there. Very primary duty is to understand how many outgoing edges. 1H, 2H, 3H, 4H, 5H. This is our prime duty. Next duty is how many productions dot has reached at the end of the production. Since this is the mother state, I'm sure none of the production would be reaching, dot would be reaching end of the production. See, look at here, dot has reached end of the production. Look at dot has reached end of the production. Look at dot has reached end of the production. Since it is the mother state, definitely it would not be there. But however, it is your prime duty to look at that as well. That's fine. These are all the two steps you need to, first you need to think. Now let us see one by one. Look at, first we need to make a pair. I0, comma, plus. Is there any edge labeled with the plus from the mother state I0? This is on E, this is on T, this is on ID, this is on open bracket, this is on F. No other combination labeled with the plus. So that I am making it as empty, or I can say it is error. Then star. Similarly, look at all the outgoing edges. None of the edges having plus star. So that I'm making it as empty. Look at other combination is ID. From the I0, ID. Yes, there is a label. Where I'm going? I'm going to the state number I5, shifting the dot operator left hand side of ID to right hand side. So that I'm writing shift 5. Action shift 5. Next open bracket. Yes, there is a edge or arc labeled with open bracket. with the open bracket, where do I reach? I do reach to the state I4. Then after reaching, what I am doing? I am shifting this operator from left hand side to right hand side. That is why it is written as S4. Next, close bracket. None of the arc is labeled with close bracket. Look at, none of the arc is labeled with close bracket. So that I am marking it as empty or error state. Dollar, none of the label is with dollar. So we can make it as empty, leave it. Now look at ETF. Is there any label goes on ETF? Yes, here one label, here one label, here one label. Then I need to note down the state number. Upon E it goes to the state number 1, I1. Upon T it goes to the state number I2. Upon F it goes to the state number 3, I3. That is what I have written, 1, 2, 3. Next, look at I1 state. Now our attention should be on the state number I1. Here we need to find out how many edges are going out. There is only one outgoing edge or arc, so that it is labeled with plus. Hold on. Next, another combination we need to look at. Is there any production dot has reached at the end? Yes, we are lucky. See, dot has reached at the end. This is the only one production dot has reached at the end. So that two different action we need to do. One is upon plus, it is going to I6. So that shift is six. To which column we need to fill? I1 row, column number 5, we need to write down shift 6. Then next, E dash produces E dot. This is the production reduced, reached at the end. So that instead of reduce action, we need to write accept action. Why we need to write accept action? See, this is the special production. I myself included artificially. This is a production called augmented production. Because of the augmented production, I am writing a new situation or action called accept. I1 and I plus I am writing S6. I1 and dollar I am writing accept. There is no other arc available, so that all other cells remains to be an empty state or error state. Fantastic. Next, let us go on to I2. Look at the state I2. How many edges are going out from I2? Only one edge is going out from I2, labeled with the star. So that where it is going? I7. For the row I2, column star, I supposed to write shift 7. Look at I2. Column star, I'm writing shift 7. Now look at internally, inside, there is only one production reached the end state. Then what I supposed to do? Whenever dot has reached end state, we need to write down reduce action with the number of this production for the follow of E. It might be confusing a little. See, for the reduce action, listen carefully. I'm just writing down reduce action, what and all you need to do. For the reduce action, you need to look at left hand side symbol. You need to go for follow computation. Then you need to refer the number of the production. Initially, first step we did for the production, we numbered. So then you need to reduce with the number. To whom you need to do? For all the follow symbols, you need to write reduce action. That's all. These are all the steps. We are working for reduce action. When we need to work for the reduce action? If the dot has reached the end of production, you need to do reduce action. First, you should understand whether dot has reached end of production or not. If it has reached, you need to do reduce action. while you are doing reduce action, what you supposed to do? You need to look at left hand side symbol. For that you need to find out follow. Then you need to refer the number of the production, which is the number labeled. Then go for follow symbol harvesting. You need to write the reduce action with the R, the number of the production. This is what we are doing. Let me write down at the end of the table. Already I have listed down for each of the non-terminal the corresponding first and follow. It is been written down. Now our duty is to harvest the follow symbol for whom? We are harvesting follow for E, capital E. Look at, we are working for I2, capital E. So harvest the follow symbol of capital E plus dollar and close bracket. Then what your duty? You need to look at the number of the production. Look at the number. Now itself we can work together. See, plus close bracket dollar. The production is E produces T. So that 2. We need to write down, R2 plus close bracket dollar. We are writing down R2. Our duty is over. Now I3. For I3, what we need to do? Look at the I3 state. Only one production. That production has reached at the end. So that we need to find out follow of F. Let us go there. Follow of F, there are four symbols. Plus close bracket dollar star. What is that F produces ID number? 6. So that I need to write down reduce 6 for these four columns with that respective state. So, sorry, 1 minute. What is this? Sorry, I need to look at I3 here. See, look at this is I5. So T produces F dot. I need to look at this production. T produces F dot. So that I need to find out follow of T. T produces F. What is the number? 4. T produces F 4. What is the follow of T? There are four symbol. So I need to write down R4. Look at R4. Written down. Now we need to look at I4. I4 is this state. How many edges are going out? One edge on E, another edge is on ID, another edge is on F, another edge is on T, another edge is on close bracket. So all are related. If it is terminal, we will be writing shift action. So that shift 5 we have written. Shift 5, shift 4. Upon ID, upon close bracket. Look at upon close bracket, it is going to the state number I4. Upon ID, it is going to I5. Upon T, it is going to 2. Upon F, it is going to 3. Upon E, it is going to 8. We need to fill up this go to table. We are done. There is one more, no more action. See, never this production, none of the production has dot at the end. So we need to stop it. Now we need to move to I5. I5 has a production, F produces ID. There is no more outgoing edge. So it is related with reduce action. For the reduce action, I need to find out follow of F. I need to find out follow of F and the number of this production. Look at follow of F is plus close bracket dollar star. This is 6. So for all the four columns, I need to write down reduce 6. Which are all the four columns? Plus star close bracket dollar. So I am writing R6, reduce 6, reduce 6, reduce 6, reduce 6. Done. Next I6, we need to go to the state number I6. I6 is here. How many edges? So many edges are going. 1, 2, T, F, open bracket, close bracket. 1, 2, 3, 4 edges. So there are 2 edges going on shift action. Open bracket, it is going to shift 4. ID, it is going to shift 5. TF, it is going to on T, it is going to 9, on F, it is going to 3. I need to first fill up this table. T and F, 9, 3. T and F, 9 and 3. so that I am going to go to table. Next, upon these two terminals, open bracket, I am going to the state number 4, shift to 4. I6, open bracket, I need to write shift to 4. Next, ID, I am going to state number 5. Upon ID, see, look at it, is coming here, I5. So I6, ID, shift 5. I6, ID, shift 5. Done. We are done with I6 state. Next, we need to look at I7. I7, F is one outgoing edge, open bracket, and ID. This is repeating. F only new, I10. F I need to write 10 state. This is same, S5, S4. But same combination, F, ID, open bracket and ID go into same state. Next, I7, only F. F is going to the state number 10. Okay, sorry, this is F going to the state number 3. Wrong, this is going to the state number 3. Now only it is coming to the state number 10. See, look at, from this F, it is coming down. This arc is coming down, connecting to F. Look at this F. Now here F is going to 10. Two more edges, open bracket, ID. I7, open bracket, ID is going to the same condition. So open bracket is same. Next, upon F, it is going to 10. Upon F, it is going to 10. Then open bracket ID, it comes with S5, S4. See, it's repeating. Done. Now we need to move to I8. I8 is one outgoing edge going to plus, one outgoing edge going to close bracket. Outgoing edge plus is going to 6, S6. This is going to S11. Close bracket and the plus. First, let me complete the plus. Plus is going to I6. I9 plus S6. It is going to the state S6. See, upon plus, it is going to S6. Upon close bracket, it is going to 11. Close bracket, S11. Next, here, where we are seeing here, yeah, only two outgoing edges, no more production, reached the dot at the end. I need to stop. Next, look at here. Here, upon dot, this upon star, this operation, star, we are only one outgoing edge. Let me complete that. So that star is I7. I9 row, seventh column is star. Star, I need to put S7. I9 star, star is second. I9 star, 7. Shift 7. Shift I9 star, shift 7. Right. Next, look at this production. Now I need to find out follow of E and the number. All the follow I need to fill up reduce action. E produces T. So that I'm going to find out follow of E. Follow of E plus close bracket dollar. What is the follow of E? E plus T. Look at the production pattern. E plus T. So what is the number? 1. So that I R1, I need to write 3 times here. Plus close bracket dollar. Plus close bracket dollar. I need to write R1. I need to write down R1. Let me reduce the table size so that all will come into one portion. Give me a minute. I'm not able to adjust. Okay, let it be. So now we are done with I10. Then we need to look at I11. I11, no more outgoing edge, only one. The production I10. I10 also I need to do. I10 we are done. I10 only we did now. I10. I9 only we did now. I9, where the duplication has come? I9, I10, I11. I9 star, one production closed, I9. Yeah, these all action we need to write R1, I9, let us, 1 minute. I9, production has reached at the end, star and T. I9T, yeah, I9 only confusion has come. Let us do. I9 star has reached I7. So that shift 7. So next, I9 dot has reached at the end. So all the e-production R1 I need to write. So I9, let me complete, then we go for here. I9 R1 plus close bracket dollar. So R1, we are done. Next, I9, there is no capitalized non-terminal. Next, we need to move to R10. R10, if you look at, dot has reached at the end. So that follow of T, number I need to fill up, that all four symbols I need to fill up the reduce action. Look at here. What is the production? T star F. T star F is 3, R3. R3 I need to write down for these four symbols. That's all, because follow of T is same. R3, close bracket and dollar. R3, right. Now let us move on to the last state, I11, no more outgoing edge. It has reached at the end. So follow of F and the number we need to write. F produces open bracket I, 5. So that I need to write down R5 here, R5, because follow symbols are there. Already we have computed. That's fine. Guys, be here for another 2 minutes. Let me complete today. So this table completion is ready. After the table completion, we need to move on to the parsing action. This will take only 5 minutes. Let us complete today itself. Look at, this is the input string. I need to load into the input buffer ID star ID. I need to end with the dollar. Same like LL parser. I am loading with the dollar. Stack, I need to push the state, starting state. What is the mother state of our all the duty? I0, so that 0 I am pushing it. Then I am pushing dollar symbol. Dollar is to indicate which is the means beginning of the stack. That's all. Dollar we are doing. So 0 and dollar combination we need to look at the table. We need to go and remember 0 and dollar. So look at 0 and dollar. This is the state, dollar. Yeah, 0 and dollar, 1 minute, something going wrong. 0 and ID, so dollar is available on the stack. 0 and ID, you need to look at the pair, 0 and ID, look at. 0 and ID, what is the action it is determined here? Yes, 5, shift 5, so that you need to shift the symbol ID to the stack and write the number 5. Look at here. You are shifting the here actions are separate, stack symbols are separate, input buffers are separate. This is one type of illustration. There is one more illustration. All together you can do within the stack itself. I will show in the next class that kind of pattern. Look at, we are shifting ID to the stack. Stack action is 5. So next we need to look at shift 5. So that shifted ID and return 5. Now we need to look at the pair 5 star, so that we need to do the next action. So 5 state star, what is action determined here? Reduce 6. How we can reduce? Reduce 6 is FID. Look at, that is why ID is replaced by F. Reduce 6, FID. This is how that, what you say, the parsing action is takes place along with the stack and along with input symbol. We need to refer the table with the number, this top of the stack number and symbol under consideration. We need to always refer 2 star, 3 star, 7 ID, $5 ID, $5, $10, $2, $1. This is the way you need to look at this number. What is on the right hand side, that number and the input symbol under scanning. Then appropriate action is demonstrated here. Dollar is the beginning of the stack. We shifted ID, then we reduced with F. Now look at 3 and star. If you look at it, will dictate you to reduce by T. Look at, let us go back to the table. State number 3, I3 and the star. I3 and the star. It is dictating us to do R4. What is R4? T produces F. So that F is replaced by T. Now we need to look at shift 7. Next, after doing T, 2 and star you need to look at. 2 and star. Go to the state 2. 2 and star. Shift 7. So that the symbol ID is star. Star is shifted. 7 is written. 7 ID. You need to look at 7 and ID. Go here. 7th state and ID. 7th state ID says dictates you to shift 5. So that you are shifting that ID also inside and you are writing 5. Now you need to compare $5. Go here. 5 and dollar dictates you to do R6. What is R6? FID. Look at here. You are going for F and you are writing 10 here. State number 10. So next, you need to look how this 10 has come. Maybe your next question. So what is the way you need to look at is the top of the number and the next symbol you need to scan. What is the symbol under scanning? You need to look at the pair. This is how you need to look at. It will guide you to reduce. With that reduction, we reach the first state E. The moment you reach the first state, you can say accept. The moment you reach. If you look at this combination, $1, go here. One and dollar, it says accept. The moment it says accept, you need to stop. One and dollar, always our duty is to look at the top of the stack and the symbol under consideration in the input buffer. For that, we need to take action. If you feel difficulty in this, today I will be sending this entire, this material in the Google Classroom, you can refer. And if you have got any doubt, you can clarify in the next class. So with that, I'm concluding today's session.